Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Last Wednesday, big inverted hammer, kind of blow off top. I like to use the word blow off top. A lot of people use that word. A lot of people understand that word instead of the blow off, instead of the inverted hammer. So last Wednesday, very similar. You had an inverted hammer off the daily Bollinger Band, which resulted in a very aggressive sell off to the bottom of the range. If you look at what we saw today, okay, especially at the close, you will notice exactly the same thing. So here's your inverted hammer. Here's the inverted hammer, right? If you go through the charts, right? If you go through the charts all the way back, okay, you'll notice that pretty much every single time you got an inverted hammer, you're going to get a move to the downside. So here is the inverted hammer here, open to the downside. Again, doesn't mean it's going to be Armageddon. We're going to go back to the March lows. All it means, it's setting up for the next day for lower prices. So here is an inverted hammer. Here's an inverted hammer. Hey guys, good evening everybody. Welcome to another edition of the AccessOfTrader.com nightly wrap-up show. Hope everybody is having a great day. Good stuff, right? Good stuff today. We'll talk about the individual pivots in a few minutes. Again, the media today, if you turn on CNBC, Bloomberg, Fox, anything, pretty much anything, they'll give you 28 reasons why the market was down today. It's just, it was just kind of, it's pretty obvious, right? They blamed it on Corona. They blamed it on China. They blamed it on everything but the reality of what actually brought down the market, okay? And we talked about this last night, and it was technical analysis. At the end of the day, when you break up market structure to its purest form, okay, anything could happen in the world, but as long as technicals and market structure are still there, usually things are going to play out. And again, you start seeing all across social media, in the last 2-3 hours talking about, again, how can you see this coming? How can you possibly see this coming? And my question is, if you, if you believe that you want to be a trader, and again, it doesn't need to be a full-time trader. You could still be a part-time trader and still participate in the markets. But if you consider yourself an aspiring trader, whether you're trading for a year, a week, 10 years, or 30 years, okay, what's your excuse for not putting in the work the night before to kind of put you in a situation to stop you, right? To stop what potentially could be about to harm you the next day. And yesterday, we talked about the inverted hammer. We talked about the ramifications of what happened every single time the markets did put in this blow off top. Again, I want to use a kind of an easier word. As we saw here as recently as a couple of weeks ago, that we saw a 7% decline. So the game plan today was, let history repeat itself. Okay, I think we had a really good game plan going into today's session. I think we kept it incredibly simplistic. Again, for all you guys who are not in the live webinar, obviously this is the first time you're hearing about this, but again, from last night's video, that's what our goal was, to see if these stocks can start confirming channels back to the downside. Now, again, nobody can talk about, as we said yesterday, you couldn't anticipate a 7% move like we saw in right here, right? This blow off top on June the 10th, but we knew there was a higher probability of something, right? Of something giving us some pretty aggressive cash flow. So usually days that the markets reverse, again, we might be prepared for it again because it's in the channels, it's in front of all of us. We have, everybody's in a level playing field, but last night we were really prepared because again, the history that was, was about to repeat itself was only a couple of weeks old. And again, for all you guys who are new traders, again, you don't need to know, as we say all the time, you don't need to know everything about trading, everything about money management, everything about psychology, but the most basic things like hammers and inverted hammers, I think no matter what type of trader you are, it's just little basic things that you can start to build your foundation on. Remember, you don't build your foundation with the roof, right, to the pouring of the concrete. You start building your foundation with the pouring of the concrete all the way up to the roof. And the idea that, again, that this was something that most people got caught off guard today and got caught with their pants below their ankles. Again, if you call yourself a trader and you claim that you do put in the work, right? It's not like something you just say, well, I do put in the work, you know, 30 minutes here, 30 minutes there. Again, this is not a hobby. I don't care if you're a part-time trader. You have to know your surroundings. You absolutely have to know the potential dangers. And every single trader, no matter if you're trading for 20 minutes or trading for 20 years, you have to put in that work the night before to protect you. Forget about even just seeking to get that alpha. Your job is to initially protect your capital. Again, it's the money you save, not the money you make, that's going to establish the value in your account. And knowing the dangers before that bell rings, okay, you will be ahead of the eight ball. And again, if you go through social media, if you go through all these financial outlets, the Bloombergs, the CNBC, the Fox Business, the CNNs, everything, okay, they were almost in shock that this was happening. And the audacity, right, the absolute amazement that a back test can come from technical levels was never even put on the table today on any of these channels, any of these focus. And again, if anybody just did a little bit of digging, just a little bit of digging, and saw what we saw the night before, inverted hammer on the major indexes, first time in weeks we saw stocks closing on the bottom of their channels, and all we needed to do today was wait for that confirmation, and good things obviously happened. So let's talk about it, right? Let's talk about the pivots, and then we'll kind of get the idea of what I think is going to happen tomorrow, okay, or at least in the next couple of days. So as you can imagine today, very, very aggressive day, okay? Absolutely aggressive, whatever you want to call it. And the funny thing is, it was just not on beta, okay? That was the most amazing part. I actually put in some longs, right? I was definitely 90% sell biased. I definitely wanted to see some longs on this channel, okay, just in case the market didn't confirm to the bottom channels. But if you look at what today did, was some of the most aggressive action you can find. So again, so here is basically from last night. Tonight we discuss how I split by day, blah 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 blah. The inverted hammer most likely means we are going to go lower. Obviously, that was the plan. And again, there were a couple of pivots to the upside. Okay, the first one was ZM. We talked about that 255 level, 255, 256 level. Zoom actually, again, held up fairly well today. If you actually look at some of the stocks that did well, Zoom was one of the ones. So, you know, we talked about this whole level here, this 255, 255 and a half, 256. That first move was pretty damn good. It almost went to 59. Again, one of the very rare names that actually did very, very well today to the long side. Actually, still looks very, very good. So if you did catch that one, I was trying to primarily watch the downside. And let's talk about this, guys. I mean, this amazing moves, absolutely amazing moves. Shop 906, if it builds below, can flush. Here was Shop, right? So here was Shop. Here was the 906 level, right? 906 went all the way down to 968. You can see why 906 was so important. That was the previous day's lows. I mean, these were all the candles. It wasn't just Shop. It was everything in beta at the same time. It was like synchronized swimming, okay? So it was a phenomenal move. So it started building above this 907 level and just got absolutely murdered, went all the way down to 868. Apron actually did very, very well. I got a bunch of emails. I'm surprised how I'm not really surprised that the stock did well, because again, Apron is food delivery. So it goes the whole, you know, it goes on the route of the whole stay at home play. Again, COVID is just, you know, spiking very, very aggressively. 1070 needs to build. And I was, you know, again, very, very surprised. Not that it went, I was very, very surprised that it went, with pretty good aggression. So here is the 1070, and the stock went all the way up to 1140. Again, if all you guys are still long, again, the theme is COVID names, right? COVID, stay-at-home, delivery names, sanitizers, conference calls, anything to do with making your life a little easier. But again, great job on Apron. Netflix, if it builds below, can flush. I thought Netflix had a shot to 457. It went a little lower than that. So here is Netflix. Right, so here's a 64 right here. It was the blow off top. Yesterday's low was 64. I thought it was going to get down to 57. It went all the way down to 54. So big moves, really big moves here. Roku, I caught really nice trade on Roku. 126 is the 5-day held three times pre-market. If it builds below, can flush. I thought there was a shot it can get down to 122. The reason why 122, that was the rising. I think it was 100-day moving average. It sliced through. Here's the 126. It sliced through, went all the way down to 120 and a half. Again, just the absolute murdering candles. Here is my only losing trade of the day. When I say losing, I lost 45 cents on Alibaba. So I got long Alibaba. I thought they were going to, this was in the morning when Zoom went. So I got long Alibaba. I thought there was going to be one shot at the 52 weekly highs. It ran up literally to like 31 and change. Stalled out. Once I saw this thing stall out, I knew everything was going to stall out. So that's when I really started focusing to the downside. I wound up losing 45 cents on Alibaba. Again, when you think about it, it doesn't make a difference. SRNE, again, SRNE, another name that, again, this is, again, I usually don't put a lot of these small cap names. Today I put two. I put SRNE and APRN on the Twitter feed. SRNE went nuts. 517, 520 needs to build. For small cap lovers, again, this has something to do with COVID, right? This is a going, again, the whole COVID theme. So it took out this 517, 520. Stock went all the way up to 560, really, really big move. And this is the first close oversupply. So for all you guys who are trading, especially the smaller names, you should watch this thing for tomorrow for continuation. Looks really, really good. NKLA is, is a very interesting name. Not because what it's doing, but what I started seeing towards the afternoon. We saw, okay, and again, for all you guys who don't know, they make like electric, like Hummers, like Hummer things. They also make like pickup, you know, those 18-wheelers and stuff. So this is like a competitor to Tesla. Let's not get crazy. But, you know, we started seeing July 100 and July 110 calls coming in for July, which is very, 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 very important, you know, important to watch. We should definitely watch this thing for the next couple of days. So this was kind of my notes ahead of pre-market. Anything on the long side, just scalp, okay? Scalp for the first 30 minutes to an hour. We closed on inverted hammers on most names. I can see buyers getting trapped on that first move, and they pull the plug. Massive, massive rug pull everywhere. Here was the next one. Too low, 212, if builds below can flush. Here was too low. Right, so here is the 212. Here's the 212, went all the way down to 209. NVIDIA got hit as well. 376, if it builds below, can flush. So here was NVIDIA, 376, right? Took out the 376, went all the way down to 365. Just destroyed, absolutely destroyed. Again, I forgot, there was another small cap name, well, smaller cap name. APT, 1820 needs to build. Again, the whole mask Corona thing name. So 1820, right? Here's the 1820. It broke 1820, went to almost 21. Again, we had literally something for everybody today, which again, I usually don't put these lower price names on the feed, but value is value. DraftKings 37.60, if it builds below can flush. I wasn't watching DraftKings, so I don't know. So I apologize. What's the symbol again? DKNG. Okay. DKNG. DKNG, DraftKings, what did I say, 37.60? Yeah, I wasn't watching it. 37.60, looks like it went to 36.50. So if you did take it, it was only a dollar move. But again, it is what it is. Beyond, again, Beyond, I still like all these things lower tomorrow. 150 if it builds below can flush. It stopped right at pre-market lows. If you see where it stopped, right, here's the 150. And it traded down right to pre-market lows of 148.5. Obviously, this is going to be the pivot going for tomorrow. Zoom, obviously, take on the way up. This is from the morning. SRNE, take on the way up. So this is definitely the trade of the day, 100%. So two levels we were watching. If you guys remember, you know, it just couldn't break out for like 2 weeks as the market was going higher. And again, the old adage goes, whatever doesn't go up must go down. 990 was the low from 2 days ago. 982 was the next low. So I said, these are the two levels. If they build, you know, they could pull the plug on this thing really, really aggressively. I thought it had a shot to get to the 940s for the rest of the week, especially if it confirmed. Again, nobody could have planned that the 990 pivot, right? And here's the 990 pivot. would have gotten this thing. It took out 990, took out 82, and that first pivot was all the way down to 969, and obviously the next pivot, 969, that we talked about, went all the way down to 950. So the first hour, you got a $45 move on Tesla. Incredible. Definitely the move of the day, especially for me as well. So phenomenal move. Roku was really good for me as well. Roku shop destroyed. And at some point, I had to say, oh my God. I mean, it started skipping dollars. So incredible move. Absolutely incredible move there. Nice move there. New lows. Amazon, 2740. If it builds below, it can flush more. Here's Amazon, right? Here's the 2740. These two candles, 2740. Went down to 2720. Still like it lower for tomorrow. Netflix, again, 461. 464 was a pivot. 461 sees 457. Went down to 454. You can see just some monster moves. Just monster moves everywhere. I mean, everywhere. Just monster moves everywhere. Just insane. Just an absolutely insane day everywhere, like literally everywhere. Going into tomorrow, and again, guys, if you thought, and I said this on Twitter, and I really mean this, okay? If you thought today was aggressive, keep something in mind. We didn't even confirm technical damage yet, just to put into perspective. Now, again, can we get a dead cat bounce tomorrow? Very possible, right? Very, very possible. If you look at the mantra in this stock market, every time we get any type of aggression, there is a bounce. However, the value for me tomorrow is to the downside, okay? If you look at how the Qs closed, it touched the 10-day moving average and bounce. If this 10-day gets confirmed tomorrow, today's sell-off will look like a day at the beach, okay? I give you my word. And when you look at the names that got hit today, they haven't even started falling, okay? If Amazon confirms the 5-day moving average, there's another 60 to 70 points in this trade. If Netflix confirms this 5-day moving average tomorrow, you have at least 14 to 18 points down, okay? If Tesla confirms this bottom channel here, okay, today's action, first it goes to 940, any close below 940, I mean, ridiculous. And you can go on and on and on. You can just literally take your favorite stocks. NVIDIA, again, held the 10-day. This 10-day confirms is another $8 to $9 there. Shop, right? Shop, look at, again, it remounted the 5-day. This 5-day gets lost tomorrow, the next day, or next week, whatever the hell it is. There's at least another 50 to 60 points to the downside. So, my sell bias, I'm definitely sell biased going into tomorrow's session. We're seeing a lot of setups here that if they confirm, and this is confirming very, very small levels of sentiment. We're not even close to technical damage. This is the most important part of kind of this video. So again, don't look at, we're not even close for a sell-off yet. The market's still in a very, very aggressive range, big upside bias. And again, a lot of names held their 5 and 10 day, but the key is going forward. If they do confirm that 5-10-day moving average, depending what stock you're looking at, there is a huge, huge potential that's going to make today look like a day at the beach. So hopefully last night's video helped a lot of you guys. For all you guys who are new traders, again, I know sometimes periods of your trading career, especially in the beginning, it'll be very, very rough. It's not going to make sense. You're not going to get it. You're going to think the walls are closing in. But again, remember, it's only the natural progression of what every trader, thousands and thousands of hundreds of thousands of traders before you have went through. So it's all part of the game. It's all part of the learning curve. It's part of your kind of initiation. The first 3 to 5 years is kind of your initiation. But don't worry, it gets better with time, experience, and the omission of bad habits. Guys, have a great night, everybody. God bless. Super job today. There's nothing really left to say. And with God's help, I'll see you all tomorrow.
Congratulations for putting in the time to take control of your trading. You're one step closer to owning your future and achieving the success you desire. Want daily trade ideas directly from Dan, straight off his personal watch list? Unlock our free PS60 Vault, where you'll get nightly updates on pivot opportunities we're watching for the next day's session. Click the link in the description to get started today.